Are you ready for the untold reason behind Günther Steiner's shocking sacking from the Haas team and his revenge master plan, which is about to shake the F1 world? Imagine getting dumped over the phone, a fate nobody deserves, especially someone as beloved in the paddock as Steiner. In a candid interview at the Autosport International show, Steiner spilled the beans on his abrupt exit and didn't hold back on how brutal it was. But what's next for him? Fans are itching to know his plans and whether he'll still have a place in the paddock. So, let's dive into this video today to know and stick around, because Steiner's revelations about his exit will tug at your heartstrings, and he might just have a surprise move up his sleeve that'll rock the F1 world. The Autosport International event just happened. It got a boost of excitement just a few days before because people found out that Günther Steiner would still be there even though he left Haas. Günther Steiner, who is Italian, is known for being very open and not holding back, but he started by sharing something sad. He said he was dumped over the phone during Christmas. This means he didn't even get to say goodbye to the team he cared a lot about. He said, "I didn't have the chance to say thank you to a few people when I left Haas F1. I would just like to thank all the team members who I couldn't give a proper goodbye to when I left. So I'll do it this way. And I also want to say to all the fans who supported us while I was there, it's fantastic. Thank you to everybody for the support I got and I am getting. So I'm mega appreciative." Günther Steiner felt hurt because he couldn't say goodbye. He said, "Yeah, it stung not to be able to say goodbye, but they all know me and they all know that I appreciate what they did. It's always best to say it to them. It would be nice to say, hey guys, thanks for what you did for the team." This incident doesn't make Gene Haas, the team's leader, look good. He was the one who started the team. Without Günther Steiner, there wouldn't even be a team. So, not letting him say goodbye is upsetting. It seems like Gene Haas isn't very interested in anything beyond the numbers on the scoreboard. We didn't expect much from him, but this lack of openness is even worse than we thought it would be. Günther Steiner, the team's former leader, experienced this coldness, which might explain why he doesn't care much about the team anymore. He said, "I don't know Gene Haas's plans for the future. He didn't share them with me. He doesn't have to. By the way, I'm not interested in it anymore." Changes in Formula One. Günther also discussed how Formula One has changed during his tenure leading Haas. He noted that the sport he loved has transformed. "Now, it's more about managing costs off the track than focusing on racing, a change that might be stifling the creativity and passion of the racers and engineers." He said, "Formula One has changed a lot since we had this model. We saw during COVID-19 how much bigger it grew, how much different it got with the budget cap, how we used it. If you look at all the other teams, they were all gearing up. They are not gearing up now. They started to gear up 3 years ago, some years ago, some last year." Further, Steiner highlighted the challenge of operating within the cost cap in Formula One. He emphasized that teams need to invest beyond the cost cap to truly benefit. In simple terms, he said, "You need to invest outside of the cost cap to get the best out of the operational cost cap. I wouldn't say it's very complex, but you need to think about how to operate with the cost cap money. How can you get the most out of it to make the car go quicker?" Many people are curious about what's next for Günther Steiner, a colorful personality in the racing world. When asked about his plans, he said, "If Formula One wants me, I don't know. In our situation, I'm not in a hurry, you know. There are always people who will see me around in Formula One. I've met many people and made many friends. If something is interesting that challenges me, yes, but just looking for a job to stay in F1, maybe that's not what I want." Günther made it clear that if he continues in Formula One, it must be challenging and meaningful. He expressed his desire to strive for more and not settle for any job. He stated, "I like to be with people, but it needs to be something where I can see a future in it." He said, "I don't just want to go there and move on to the next thing. I want to do something where you can achieve something and you try to get somewhere and then I will do it." Support from fans. Fans of Formula One would love to see Günther succeed because of his colorful personality and dedication to the sport. While nobody is guaranteed race wins, fans would root for someone like Günther to achieve success. What could the future hold for Günther Steiner? There are a couple of possibilities that might come his way soon. One short-term option for Günther is to focus on his off-track ventures. In addition to Formula One, he has other businesses to manage. Stepping back from the intense world of racing could give him a chance to find peace and organize his life. He might even have time to explore new opportunities and expand his interests. But how long will he stay away from the racing world? Unique traits of F1 people. In Formula One, people need to have a certain mindset. They thrive on challenges, constant stimulation, and progress. For someone like Günther Steiner, who is always seeking new challenges and growth, simply relaxing in peace might not be satisfying. Günther Steiner mentioned something interesting about the friendships he's made in Formula One. He talked about his early days at Red Bull, where he worked alongside Christian Horner to lead the team into a new era. This makes us wonder if we might see a dynamic duo emerge on the track, similar to their close friendship off the track. Imagine Günther Steiner teaming up with Mattia Binotto for a new adventure in team leadership. Both are Italian engineering experts with experience in leading teams in Formula One. While some might worry about having too many leaders, the idea of this partnership is exciting. Where could we see this partnership in action? There are two potential avenues for them to explore their collaboration, whether it's leading a team together or taking on new roles within Formula One. The prospect of seeing these two talented individuals working together is something many fans would love to witness. Audi, which is taking over Sauber, is looking for top-tier personnel to lead their team. They have set their sights on Mattia Binotto and are actively seeking more engineering talent to revitalize their program. Binotto's experience as a technical director could give their engineering efforts a much-needed boost. If Binotto and Steiner were to team up, sharing roles as chief technical officer, CTO, and team principal, it would create a formidable partnership. Not only would this duo enhance the technical side of the team, but their star power would also attract attention from fans, especially after a period of negative news and silence surrounding the new entrant. Potential at Alpine. Another avenue for Günther Steiner could be Alpine. While it would involve stepping back from direct control, which might be a welcome change after his intense time at Haas, Alpine could offer him an intriguing opportunity. Taking on a technical role would allow Günther to reconnect with the essence of the sport. Moreover, his involvement would bring additional star power to the team, potentially elevating their profile in the eyes of fans and the wider F1 community. Investments from figures like Ryan Reynolds could spark interest in a team's potential transformation. The key to a successful return on investment is turning around a team that may be perceived as indifferent or unlikable. By injecting charisma and likability into the team, there's a chance to attract positive attention. Having a personality like Günther Steiner, known for his candid and colorful character, could inject excitement into the team dynamics. His interactions, such as playfully reprimanding drivers, would generate media buzz and draw more attention to a team that has struggled to make an impact both on and off the track in recent years. Regardless of where Günther Steiner ends up, many hope to hear his voice again in Formula One coverage. Whether he partners with Binotto, embarks on a challenging journey with Alpine, or simply makes occasional media appearances, it's unlikely that we've heard the last from him. Steiner's presence has left a mark on the sport, and his future endeavors are sure to garner interest and attention. So, what do you think of why Steiner got sacked and his revenge master plan? Comment below and subscribe for more.